he gone?
How did you let him go?
He transformed
again.
Him. What happened?
He disappeared. Again.
Can you hear me? Just wait there. I'll find you.
Find him. Get him back.
He was just there. How could you lose him? How could she lose
How
him?
How could she
find him?
Senua, you remind me of a story that the Northmen tell about a young woman warrior. Her name is Hervor, the daughter of a berserker, born after he was killed. She's a wild, willful child who teaches herself to fight with weapons. When she learns where her father is buried, her only desire is to reclaim the treasure buried with him, but above all, the sword, Tyrfing.
Don't touch the walls.
You don't know what they might do.
Turn back.
She has to keep going.
It's not safe here.
She has to keep going.
If you go down there, no one can save you.
It's too scary.
I can hear him.
Hervor disguises herself as a man to join a band of warriors, and soon becomes their leader. When they come to the island where her father is buried, her men do not want to go ashore. They say that evil haunts the island, and that it is a worse place by day than other places are by night. Fearless, she lands alone. There are many grave mounds, and all of them have ghostly flames burning over them. She comes to the grave mound of her father after passing through these ghostly fires as though they were mist. The flames I passed through were real enough. Damn the Northmen to hell.
Find another way. It's not working.
You have to use your mind. Where can you go?
You're failing. Find another
think.
Way.
Think. Think.
Focus.
It's not him.
It's not him.
We told you. We told you it was a trick. It's not Dillian. You're too close to stop. It's in there.
Father?
I'm leaving. I've decided. I think it will be good for me.
It's the darkness. It's speaking through.
No, Dad, it's me. I think I can beat it. In my own way.
I can see the darkness in your eyes, child.
I met a boy.
Boy?
The chief, that's her.
No.
He said he could help me.
It's a trick.
He said I could be normal.
Normal?
Yes.
No boy is going to save you. No one can. When they see the rot growing inside you,
no.
They will turn their back on you. The gods can only fix you through my hand. You're going nowhere.
No.
You will not defy the gods. Come, child, take my hand. Come. Senua.
No! I am leaving!
You cannot escape the darkness. Your curse will make everyone suffer. You will have blood on your hands!
I saw once a plague strike northern lands of ice. It was so terrible that not the oldest man among us could remember the like. Hundreds died. The sickness took nearly every person younger than 40 and many older. And where dying mothers gave birth, the marks of the plague were on the babes as they came out of the womb.
Where are we? I don't like it.
This place feels...
What is this place?
This place feels...
It's... creepy.
Creepy.
It feels wrong.
It feels strange.
Where is it? Where are we?
Turn back.
This is wrong.
There he is.
There he is.
The light.
Go towards it.
He's in the house.
He's going in.
He's disappearing.
Follow him.
Don't let him disappear.
The air.
Where's it gone?
Keep going.
How do you find it?
It's just a dust.
It's a test. Like the old warrior trials. Lillian will help me.
The stench of rot. She can almost taste it. Do you smell it? Don't worry, not everyone can. It was a warm spring day when she went to the river with Dillian and the others. To the water. She could taste the rot. But no one else could. She knew something was wrong. Something sinister. She begged them to leave, but they just laughed at her. But soon enough, as the bodies piled up, no one was laughing.
Fix it. You have to fix it.
And they knew that she was not like that.
Quick, get to the house. get to the house and finish this trial.
It doesn't finish until you get to the house.
Before he disappears, Senua.
You have to get in.
The Northmen speak of a death moon, a light shaped like a half moon that appears inside a house and goes around the walls. I once saw the death moon appear at a farm, and first the shepherd died, then a guest died, and then the farmhands, and then the farmer and six of his men drowned at sea. But that is not the end of it, because the dead return to haunt the living. If you see the death moon, then beware, because there will be death in that house.
Senua, come to me. Where are you?
I'm here. I'm right here.
Are you in there?
Where is he?
Come out if you are.
You have to fight him.
Delia!
Towards it. Find
focus.
It.
Focus. Focus.
Look. One has to find one more. One dozen.
Thank you.
Run!
Oh,
run!
Don't let it look at you!
Don't let it see you, it's coming!
No.
Move away! You're lost again!
Senua! What happened?
They're blaming me for the plague. They say that I'm cursed. What if they're right?
How would they know such a thing? Are they gods? None of us are. They're just people. Good people, but they're scared. They're afraid of what they can't see. Like children scared of the dark. They make up stories to fill the void. Doesn't it look true?
What if my father was right?
You have to step out of this darkness. Let them see who you really are, like I have. You're not a monster.
Without you, this darkness has made me a monster.
What if this is pointless? What if you're wrong?
Do with the sword.
What if we're wrong?
The sword will never be yours.
What if this is the end?
It's just a trick.
You've been fooled before. You could be fooled again.
Being dusted.
You don't know.
I want to tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur. The second son of Odin. He was beautiful, good, and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him. Only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die. The Northmen tell this story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams.
You can.
Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world. Fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, sickness. Swear an oath not to harm her sons. One by one, they each make their vow. Neither weapons nor wood will injure him, Baldur's mother boasts. Only Loki, father of Hela, mistress of death, is not amused.
Seems so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillian taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching.